Hey y'all, welcome to Freedom Makers. I'm Amanda, and today I thought I'd show you guys a few projects I've been working on. Over on Facebook, I showed a picture not long ago of me working on something with a knitting loom, and since then I've created several different things, including the hat. And so I thought I'd show you guys kind of what I've been working on, what I'm working on now, and a trick that you can use with your knitting loom. What started this was a few hats, so I decided to make my daughter some hats. This one is her size, and she loves them. I've made her a couple in different colors that were her preference. I let her pick her own yarn. And so then I decided, well, hey, I'm gonna make myself some to match. So I made this one for myself to match hers. And then I did a brown. And then this one I have twice. I have two of these. Just because they're kind of addictive. Once you start working with a loom, it's really fun. It's very fast. And I just really enjoy it. So I also decided to make myself a scarf. This, because it is made on a loom, it is double-sided. So when you're working in a circle like this, you have two sides. So it smushes flat, and then that is your scarf. So it's double thick, and it's very toasty. I have not finished the edges on this one. I was thinking about making some fringe, but I haven't decided for sure if I'll do that or not. And it's just really toasty warm. So my daughter saw this one that I made for myself. It's just something that I wanted to make for me, just that was high quality, that I had made with my own hands. That's very important to me. I just really love the feeling of having something that I made myself. And so she decided she would like one. So I let her go and pick out her own colors. And this is what I'm currently working on for her. It is about, 3 feet long or so. And it won't be too long before that's ready for her. You want your scarf to be about the same height as you are long. So that just gives you a lot of great room to wrap, and it's like the standard. You want it to be as long as you are tall. So I've seen many people show how to loom knit, and most of them use their fingers like this to wrap. And there's nothing wrong with that, except that it takes forever. So instead, a friend showed me that you can use a straw. So I have a straw here. This is a very sturdy straw. It's not very pliable. This one is just a very thick plastic. So I cut it about 3 inches long. And on the end that is closest to my loom, I smushed it a little bit because it was just a little bit too wide to fit in between comfortably. To put the straw on, you have to start with it. So you're going to use this on your very first row when you first start your project. And then it's much, much faster. You can see it's much quicker than manually going around each peg. And so I really prefer this method because it's very fast. I've been able to crank out several items much more quickly with the straw method. So if you loom knit and you have not seen this before, this might be worth trying the next time you start a project. So if you are a loom knitter or a knitter at all or a crocheter, I'd love to hear what you're into in the comment section below. If you're working on a project right now, share that with us as well, because I'd love to get some new ideas. And it's really just fun to see what other people are working on and what you've made. I just think it's a very important skill that's gone by the wayside, and it's a useful skill. You can make things for you and your family that you may not be able to afford something of a really great quality where you could buy the yarn. So I really have enjoyed getting into this and learning more about this. I think that yarn arts are very important, and it's a skill that's dated back for centuries, so it's very interesting to me. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like, share, subscribe if you haven't already, and you will see other videos just showing what we're doing here at Freedom Makers and how we are learning about old style crafts and learning to can and different things like that. It's just very important to me to know how people lived back in the day, so that if anything ever happens and we need those skills, they're still alive in us. So thank you guys so much for stopping by. I appreciate each of you, and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye, guys.